Hello and welcome. I'm James Murphy, and today we're going to be looking at what's the fastest way to loop in Python. So just as an example task, we're going to loop through the numbers 0 to n minus 1, where n is going to be some big number like this, and just add them up, you know, something to do in the loop. Which one do you think is faster, using a while loop or a for loop? You can see in both cases, we're doing essentially the same work, but one of them is using a while loop, and the other one is using a for loop. In both cases, we initialize a sum to 0, and then loop over all the numbers, adding to the sum. We'll test to see which one is fastest by using the timeit method from the timeit library. Let's just go ahead and run it. Okay, and you can already see that it took a surprising amount of time, over 15 seconds for the while loop, but just under 10 seconds for the for loop. So it looks like the for loop is the clear winner in this case. I would like to point out that I am recording this at the same time that I'm running this code, so these numbers are largely inflated, but if you run the code at home, and I have done this, you will find that the ratios are approximately the same. So we saw that although the for loop and the while loop are doing essentially the same thing, the while loop took over 5 seconds longer. Why is that? Well, the unfortunate fact of the matter is that compared to the C programming language that Python is written in, Python itself is an extremely slow language. In order to do the for loop, Python passes the iteration off to C code that works with the iterator of this range object. That's all written in C, so all of the iteration part of it is actually done in C. All the bounds checking and incrementing of this variable I is done in C, and it's only this statement which is actually done in Python. In contrast, in the while loop, both the check to see whether I is less than n and incrementing I, both of those things are done in Python, not in C. We can confirm that this is actually the issue by adding in these functions. So what these functions do, these are modifications of this for loop function that add in a redundant operation that doesn't actually need to be there. So in this one, we add in the increment. So we increment I. Now, of course, this variable I is going to be incremented by the range iterator on its own. So this I plus equals 1 actually has no noticeable effect besides running and taking up time. Similarly, in this one, we add in this redundant check to see whether I is less than n. And then in this one, we add in both the check to see if I is less than n and the redundant increment. So I've just given them their own lines in the timeit code, and let's go ahead and run it again and see how long they take. So as you can see, just adding in these redundant operations to the for loop implementation, that it significantly increased the time. This I plus equals 1 shouldn't really do anything, but adding that in alone has practically made the for loop as slow as the while loop. Similarly, we can see that adding in the redundant if I is less than n check also adds a few seconds to the computation. Then worst of all is doing both the redundant I plus equals 1 and test to see if I is less than n. That's coming in at around 19 seconds, making it the slowest one and showing us that doing these useless operations, just because they're in Python and not in C, even though they have no real effect, is really slowing our code down. Okay, that's pretty sad. So is there anything that we can do to go faster than a for loop or a while loop? One thing that should come to mind is use built-ins over loops whenever you can. So this implementation uses the built-in sum, which does a for loop under the hood, and the built-in range, of course, rather than writing the loop ourselves. So let's see how fast that goes. Wow, that is a lot better than both the for loop and the while loop. So you can see, if ever you have the ability to use a built-in over an actual loop, you should definitely take that route. But can we do even better than that? How about let's try using NumPy, which is built for doing these kind of operations quickly. I went ahead and imported NumPy and added this sum NumPy function. The NumPy sum just creates the range as a NumPy range, and then uses the numpy.sum to sum it up. So this is essentially equivalent to this one, but it's using NumPy functions instead of Python functions. And again, NumPy is primarily written in C, so as much of this as possible should be happening in C, not Python. Let's try running it again. Okay, so that one was much faster. Compared to the others, this is the only good one. Because the entire summing operation is written in C, this whole function essentially is one C call. So both the iteration, but also the adding itself is done in C. And that's what makes this one the fastest of them all. The only downside to this one is that this creation of a range actually creates that whole array in memory. So I just made a 100 million element array in memory. So if I had chosen a bigger number, I might not have enough memory to do that. Comparatively, this sum range, this range doesn't actually create all those elements in memory. So this sum could actually run no matter how big n is without worrying about memory constraints. But in this case, I think it's definitely worth it to give up the memory and let the sum happen in C rather than Python. So you might be asking, is there anything that we can do to beat out NumPy? You would be hard-pressed to find a faster implementation, even in C, for this sum operation. I think NumPy does a really good job at making this happen quickly. So the only feasible way of making this happen faster is to know the answer ahead of time. That's why the final implementation is to use math knowledge. What are we doing? We're adding up the first n-1 integers. Well, there's a formula for that. You may not know it, but you can certainly look it up, and here it is. So this is pure Python, and it's going to beat out the C1 for sure by a lot. Let's go ahead and test it. And of course, it is no contest. The pure math implementation is not even in the same league. NumPy is good, but knowing the answer ahead of time, you just can't compete with that. In conclusion, what's the fastest way to loop in Python? Well, the unfortunate truth of the matter is the fastest way to loop in Python is not to loop in Python. If you have the great luxury of being able to compute the answer mathematically ahead of time, definitely do that. Your next best option is to have the whole looping and everything that you want to do be done in a pure C function. Your next best option is to call a pure C function that can do all of the looping and your operations for you. Failing that, use Python built-ins like sum or map rather than writing a loop yourself. As a last resort, use a for loop over a while loop. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like the video, don't forget to leave a like, a comment, and if you especially like the video, don't forget to subscribe. It really helps me out. Thanks. See you in the next one.